So, I haven't done story mode all the way through yet, that I can recall. So, what my plan is to finally complete story mode, get all the way through, unlock all the traits, but I'm intrigued because I usually have a very set method, of how I do it. It's very logical, it's very structured, it's very straightforward, and I don't know if I'm going to end up falling into that again, or if I'm gonna let it go more on the flow. We're just gonna see how it ends up unfolding as it goes. But, I guess we'll see how brave I am. It's process. Okay. And I'm also battling the one screen for basically two functions. So we'll see how well that flies as well. But, okay. Let's see how well I can survive this. It's always intriguing to what Adam and Eve look like. I tend to be relatively okay with this game though. And I can kind of remember the system of the islands. I think you always go north, northbound. I think they've done a really good job with this game. Such a good job with this game. I'm gonna be a little biased because I love strategical thinking, logical process, and survival. It's like a combo that I love, and it's not for everyone. But I've put a lot of hours into this game. Like a lot. Alrighty. Ouch, that hurt. You're all alone, stranded on an island. Away from home. Oh, dramatic. I already know all the like I've played this game for time, so I'm just gonna click on that little Adam here. He's super duper cute. Can you still walk Adam? Yeah, no. I mean it's more of a slide, but you can still slide. That's okay. I always use the space bar, but the space bar is sneaky. Keep tabs on it. It is extremely easy to accidentally spacebar when you haven't actually looked at all your niche links. And yeah, that can be quite detrimental at times because apparently they're still hungry and they were still looking to note. Spacebar it. There seems to be plenty of food on this island. Let's have a little nibble. Pathway strains, let's do another island. Yes. See, the aging, that goes really fast. Remember that, especially when you get into a system, so make sure that doesn't happen too much. Again, I reckon it's only fair that we pick the bush clean and head north. It's a stray. Alright. We're heading north. Let's go. Let's go, man. I actually don't enjoy talking about the turtle and the system. I'm going to keep that because I do feel. I just like creating balance. I don't know how the turtle system is. I feel like the turtle is quite dominant in the nature of the surface. I might use the turtle. I can very easily get my imagine people that that can get into like a very like story mode, and they like can really add depth and creativity and storylines. Like, I'm not usually like that. I'm trying to become more so, but I'm not usually like that. I'm definitely more so logical strategies, methodology that works. We've got our amazing senses, and we have this Missy stealing from our. Oh, it's like, okay, so this is definitely not Eve. But here we have Eve. Okay, I should have picked that she was going to be a blue platypus. That makes a lot of sense. Alrighty, well, we have beautiful Evie here, who we're going to definitely add to the tribe. Okay, and I'm aware of the animal sex, and you can also tell which is a female and which is a male, which I don't think it says up there. Animal sex is displayed in the bottom corner. Oh yeah, males have manes. It's also a very, very convenient way that I didn't know for a very, very long time. It's actually makes things a little bit easier, turns out. Okay, get rid of all notifications. Notifications in this game are a little annoying. They could be more efficient. Alright, so. See, I think it's going to come up asking about this next time, but I'd love to see what she's actually got helpful for. Feeding from the bottom can be convenient. More so though, if you can spread out a word and she can't. Digging 2. Moving 3. Swimming 2. To see what this uncovers. I know this hasn't mentioned it. I'm jumping ahead a little bit, but I love doing mutations first. I mean, this is something else that I'm very curious about, so if anyone knows, let me know. So, when... Mine's gone suddenly blank. With the mutations, do they get applied to the offspring if you do it before they mate, or it doesn't matter and you can do it after and it will still apply to the offspring? Never looked that up. Really curious about that. So if someone wants to do the research for me, that would be amazing. Okay. Who's the best collector? Oh, actually, you might as well get them breeding now. So, what traits has she got here that I'm not a fan of? She'd probably be better with a better nose, because we don't have any swimming traits. She's got heat bodies of recessive. So we might look to get rid of the snout. Worried about the blind eyes there. Don't really need a tail to stay down the water. And whilst we're not so strong, stripes would be a really good pattern to have. But it would be handy because well, Adam is strong at that point. Okay, but we need our maternal line. So what is our main... Well, I usually go like, to me, they're royal colours. Kind of royal colours. I'm going to make them royal colours. So we'll go the royalish colours. And that's now going to be our Adam and Eve bloodline. So let's focus on the things that she has now so we can clear them out. I think having stripes is important because we're not super strong. Create the ideal niche lane that I'm after, And I used to have like a whole sheet. Like I printed off a sheet for this. Like this is some serious stuff. And it had like what would be the ideal nose, horns, eyes, head, like ears, body, paws. I actually had like a whole system which had every single one of these. Yeah, these were all listed on there. And I'd have a point system. So if they had the traits that I was after, they would have a point system. I might still do this because I know I find it really satisfying. It's so much easier to keep track of. Storylines, I'm not my strongest point, but we'll see how they go. So, we'll see if I fall into that. In fact, maybe even that is something that you guys can help me do. Like, we can pick how it's going, like what our ideal initially is, pick how it's going to look, what features like we'd like to aim for. We can basically like set every single one of these traits that we think would be the most beneficial, and we can do the point system, because this is my system, it's very 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 efficient. With the point system, you match, unrelated obviously, the two highest point animals together, and before you know it, like it's really quick to get, then have that offspring. And usually I'd have like the offspring would be as soon as the offspring has more points than the parents, then that's when I would stop breeding the parents, and then it would be kind of passed on to the offspring to then kind of carry the breeding. I'd keep tabs on like particular genes that I wanted to keep in the line too. Like I probably fall into this. It's very, very methodical. It's very logically placed structure. Like I don't know if you guys did masculine or feminine or not. Like I am a very, very spiritually minded person, and like to me, I have a very logical masculine mindset. For someone who comes across, I guess, quite feminine. I'll probably go into my teachings of masculine and feminine knowing me later, so if you guys have any questions, feel free to ask and I'll direct you in some clarity, because I live in the world of masculine and feminine. I'll be interested if that comes up. So, we haven't decided on anything to do with it yet. Again, look to have good eyesight. I haven't put that in there yet already. As the focus. And then let's start with that. Super easy, super straightforward. Easy peasy point of pie. And she is not very strong at gathering, but oh, we do not have this knowing. Okay, it might be easy if she just picks at the bush. Yes, and nest. We'll find her a nest. Oh, that's right. They can breed on the first. Oh, no, I forgot that was before. I forgot that was before. That must have been from any hunt. That's another thing that I met in Instagrams, which is really prominent, is like how other animals interact with the world. Like rabbles, like the little rabbits that kind of grow around, and they eat the berries off the bush. I never realized they eat the berries off the bush. So you actually need to kind of keep on top of the rabble population, because they will eat all the berries of the bush. I didn't realize that was a thing. It's a thing. And obviously, like, you're wandering niches, so before they join the tribe, or if they don't join the tribe, they're still going around trying to collect food. So they will eat your food, they'll dig up things, even if it's not something they're very good at, they will stick. Like, usually if you see them in one spot, time after time, can sometimes hear what interaction they're doing if you know what to listen for. They will stay in one spot for a long time. You think, oh, they're just chilling there. No, like they're constantly trying to do things, and they're probably trying to dig up a root with these little velvet paws that can't even dig into the dirt. So the wanderers can be quite intriguing. I never realized that they had all these all this going on in the background. It just really, really intrigued me. All right, so we find the nest. Always a nest on here. Oh, we might just build the nest. he looks like.
Oh, he looks so cool.
Oh, and actually Thunder could be an interesting one. God, we have a little Thunder Junior. We have like a stripeless Thunder. You didn't get the same color in, so cute. He looks stunning. I think I'm gonna rename him. It's kind of like Thunder, but less striped. I mean, it could be Thunder and Rumble.
Yeah.
I reckon that would be a bit cute. Let's go and Rumble. Cute. Okay, and you end up getting the digging pool. What else did you get from Mama? We have antennae. I didn't realize that was in the background. I think antennae can be really helpful. Probably more so in some of the other worlds. When you're in something like the... I can't remember what it's called. These easy times. The grasslands. There, grasslands. There's food abundance, so... Rain is quite frequent too, but sometimes I can be handy in some other areas. Oh, like for example, probably handy in the snow, because then you can actually acknowledge when blizzards are coming in and you can get out of like the heavy snow because the initialings aren't like for it and stuff like that. Alrighty, well, let's see what we got here then. Bunny mounds, it took me a long time to we'll see what comes up. Wearing earrings, I guess that might have been a bad idea. They're nice earrings, but we're kind of digging into any of these. Awesome, you awesome guys have just got. Might as well get Mummy to actually use her digging abilities. 3, that's not too bad. Don't know whether you can get, keep an eye for the leeches, which I think you can actually get in there. So I might keep Dad nearby and have them have one more digging together. Oh, that's so cute. They were definitely not screwing. It was making love. This is a bunny mound that can be handy to have in sights. Gorgeous Tammy. I like Tammy. She kind of reminds me of oh, what's the red dog? There's a cartoon with a red dog that looks like that kind of red. Vendetta? It's like on the tip of my tongue. If you guys can remember, feel free to let me know in the comments. Okay. Now.
Alright, legends, well, I'm gonna leave it on that cliffhanger. We will see what our nichelings do to tackle this first encounter with a predator in the next episode, which will be linked, the playlist will be linked below, so you can jump on and follow up if that happens. Obviously, you can subscribe to the channel too, and you'll know when the next endeavors happen. Keeping track of all the excitement. But now I'm going to pop off. If you wanted to watch this in a more intimate way, I stream quite frequently on my Twitch channel, which is also below. So give that a sus. I dip into a few other games such as Love the Sims 3. And I also dip into a few other Nicks and Nacks. So you can check that out on my Twitch channel. And yeah, I also have a empowerment group as well. So if you're interested in getting self-empowerment, I've got those links below as well. I am an empowerment coach, so you can give that a look. But I guess I'll leave it at that and catch you next time. All right, see you, legends.